Friends, welcome back. We'll continue our discussion on supply concepts. Give me a minute. I'll be sharing the screen with you. Tell me if screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So definition part we have already covered. What is the goods, all this thing, business, etc. Constitution we have already understood. What is the meaning of person, we covered it. Now coming to concept of supply. We'll quickly recapitulate what we have learned in the preceding class. So I told you from the very beginning that section 7 and section 8 both are relevant to understand the concept of supply. Section 7 broadly talks about the meaning and scope of supply, and section 8 explains two more things, that is what is composite supply and what is mixed supply. Those things will be explained in section 8. And to understand the meaning which is provided in section 7, we have to go through three schedules. Schedule 1 talks about certain activities which will be treated as supply even when there is no constitution. Constitution is not received, but still that will be regarded as supply. And schedule 2 talks about the activities and transaction which has to be treated as supply of goods or supply of services. So in fact, this particular schedule, schedule 2, segregates that in some specific issues, these are the activities which are supply of goods and these are the activities which are supply of services. And Schedule 3 talks about the activities and transaction which shall be treated neither as supply of goods nor as supply of services. The meaning that is a negative list, those activities shall not be regarded as supply of goods or supply of services. Okay. Then coming to Section 7, in the first subsection, defines in an inclusive manner what is the meaning of supply. It covers sale, transport, barter, exchange, license, rental, lease, disposals made or agreed to be made for consideration. All these things are supply. But here it says it has to be made in the course of or furtherance of business. That means it should be a commercial activity. In the course of business or in the course of furtherance of business, the activity must have been carried out. And if that is so, and if that is for a consideration, then that is supply. Then clause B talks about importation of service, that is import of service for consideration. And even if it is not in the course of or in the furtherance of business, even if it is not in the course or furtherance of the business, still it will be regarded as supply. That is part clause B. And clause C talks about activities specified in Schedule 1. Shall be regarded as supply even if it is without consideration. So first case you see consideration is mandatory, then in the course of business and furtherance of business, this condition is also mandatory. Second case for import of services, you have seen consideration is mandatory, but it need not be the course of or furtherance of business. Still it can be regarded as supply. Point C talks about without consideration, still activity can be regarded as supply. Now coming to first Schedule 1. Schedule 1, as you can see, list of activities where consideration is not involved, but still it can be regarded as supply. Like permanent transfer or disposal of business assets where ITC has been availed. Then supply of goods and services are both to a related person. Or supply between distinct persons. What is distinct person? I had explained to you at that point of time. Again, I'll be explaining what appropriate time. Right, those kind of activities are also supply even if there is no consideration. Okay, and it also specifically provides that the gifts not exceeding 50,000 rupees in value in a financial year by employer to employee shall not be treated as a supply. If employer gives a gift to an employee not exceeding rupees 50,000 rupees during the year, then that will not be regarded as a supply. Then supply made by principal to agent is also supply, or agent to principal is also supply, provided the agent undertakes to supply such goods on behalf of the principal. or agent undertakes to receive the goods on behalf of the principal, as the case may be. Import of services by a person from a related person is also supply, even if it is without consideration. So these are the four items, or four classes of items which are specifically included, where even without consideration it will be regarded as. Okay. Now, subsection 1A of section 7 explains certain activities of transaction constitute a supply in accordance with the provision 1 shall be treated either as supply of goods or as supply of services as per schedule 2. Now we have to go to the schedule 2. We have to see which are the transactions which will be regarded as supply of goods and which are the activities or transactions which will be regarded as supply of services. Schedule 2, I had shown you from the side. Again, I am showing you here that how it can be regarded as supply of goods and supply of services. First of all, transfer. Transfer in the title of goods is a supply of goods. Transfer of right in the goods or undivided share in the goods is supply of services. Transfer of goods under an agreement which stipulates that property in the goods are to be transferred in a future date on full payment of consideration, that will be regarded as supply of goods. Leasing, tenancy right, easement, license, they are regarded as supply of services. Leasing or letting out will be regarded as supply of services. Any treatment or process which is applied on some other person's goods is to be regarded as supply of services. And coming to the fourth part of Schedule 2, transfer of business assets. When the business assets are transferred or disposed of under the direction of a person carrying on the business. Okay, whether or not this transfer is for a consideration, this will be regarded as supply of goods. Business asset transfer will be regarded as supply of goods, whether or not for consideration. Okay, but when the business asset is put to any private use or are made available for somebody else's private use, then that particular activity will be treated as supply of services. And where a person ceases to be a taxable person, then assets of his business shall be deemed to be supplied in the course of business and furtherance of business immediately before he ceases to be a taxable person. Unless, but there are two exceptions to this thing. When business asset is transferred or business is transferred as a going concern, that means as a running business, it is transferred from one person to another person. Or when the business is carried on by any personal representative who is deemed to be a taxable person, that means another personal representative who is a taxable person is also carrying out the business. In these cases, transfer of assets will be treated like this. Some cases, goods, some cases, services. Renting of immovable property is supply of services. Construction of complex building of civil structure, etc., all of them are supply of services. Okay, so this is Schedule 2. Now we'll come to the subsection 2 of Section 7. We're still in the Section 7, Subsection 2. You see, what Subsection 2 talks about. We have already covered Subsection 1 and Subsection 1A. Notwithstanding anything contained in Subsection 1, activities or transactions specified in the Schedule 3 or B, such activities, transactions undertaken by central government, state government or local authority which they are engaged as public authorities, just give me a moment. Point B is that such activities or transactions undertaken by central government, state government or any local authority in which they are engaged as public authorities, as may be notified by the central government on recommendation of the central council, shall be treated neither as supply of goods nor a supply of services. Okay, that means there are some activities or some transaction which are specified in Schedule 3, or such activities and transaction, central government, state government, or public authority. Okay, maybe they declare on the basis of these are certain transactions which are undertaken by central government, state government, or public authorities, which GST Council may recommend, and they will be treated neither as supply of goods nor supply of services. We'll quickly go through what are these activities which are specified in Schedule 3. You see, if you see the Schedule 3, you can see these are the activities and transactions which shall be treated neither as supply of goods nor as supply of services. First of all, services by employee to employer. The provision of service that employee is making to the employer in the course of or in connection with his employment, that is not supply of services, that is also not supply of goods. Services made by court or tribunals, they are also not supply of services or supply of goods. Then functions performed by MPs, that is member of parliaments, member of state legislature, member of panchayats, member of municipalities, member of local authorities, all these services they provide, they are not going to be recognized as supply of services or supply of goods. The duties performed by a person who holds any post in pursuance of the provisions of the constitution in that capacity, that means this constitutional recognized provisions, that means services performed by, let us say, Chief Justice of India, Chief Election Commissioner of India, these kind of positions, they are neither supply of goods nor supply of services. Those activities will not be coming under GST purview by virtue of Schedule 3. The duties performed by any person as chairperson or member or director in a body established by central government, state government, or local authority. These kind of government bodies, their chairperson, their director, their members, the kind of service they provide, that will not be regarded as supply of goods or supply of services. Services of funeral, burial, cremation, mortuary, including transportation of deceased. If these activities are involved, they are neither treated as supply of goods nor treated as supply of services. There are some organizations which provide this kind of services, that provide certain goods related to this. They are neither provision of goods, nor neither supply of goods nor supply of services. Sale of land and sale of building, they are also coming under this category, neither supply of service nor supply of goods. Auctionable claims other than lottery, betting, and gambling. They are also not lottery, betting, and gambling will be regarded as supply, but actionable claims are not, will not be regarded as supply of goods or supply of services. Okay, so this is broadly section 1, clause 2. Section 7, subsection 2. Okay, now we are coming to section 7, subsection C. Okay. Here what it talks about, subject to subsection 1A and 2, the government may, on recommendation of the council, specify by notification the transaction which shall be treated as A, supply of goods and not supply of services, or B, a supply of services and not supply of goods. So this is the power given to the government. Government here means central government, we have understood. So GST Council may recommend, and government may declare that these are the supply of goods, they are not supply of services. Or government may also may specify that these are the supply of services and not supply of goods. This power is also given. Okay, so this is about section 7. Okay, how many subsections we learn in section 7? Who can tell me? How many subsections are there?
The 3.
Three or four?
I got confused. I don't know.
Subsection 1, subsection 1A, subsection 2, and subsection 3. Okay. 1A, this is a new subsection which has been inserted. So 1A, 2, then 3. Okay, all these things we have learned, you see. This is subsection 1 we learned, then we learned subsection 1A, then subsection 2, all these blue color slides are direct bare act, provisions from act, then subsection 3. So there are four subsections we have learned. These four subsections are learning, these four subsections are important, and related schedules are important for us, because supply is a very important concept. And we'll be proceeding further, we'll be seeing many related concepts also. So, therefore we have to remember that all these three subsections are related schedules. Now, let me quickly analyze. It requires a lot of analysis in fact. So, subsequently we'll be analyzing all these things in detail. Now, if I analyze at these trees at a very broad level, we'll be making detailed analysis also. Without that, it will be difficult for us to remember or to digest the concept of supply. First point is that you have seen the definition is quite inclusive. Is it not? Are you agreeing to this? Inclusive definition or not? Supply definition.
Go back to inclusive.
Inclusive definition. Okay. And again, you see, when he defines the term supply of goods includes all forms of supply of goods or services or both, then what is written here? Can you read?
Such as.
Such as means when the word such as is used, that means the law is trying to give you some examples only. So it cannot be exhaustive. That means only examples. That doesn't mean that only those are the instances of supply. Okay. So you can say the second analysis is that use of the word such as means what the law has tries to explain is our examples. Okay. Third point is that you see whether it is supply of goods or supply of services or both, all of them will attract GST. Money securities does not attract GST. Why money and security does not attract GST? Because money is not, in the earlier classes we have understood what is the definition of goods and what is the definition of services. Do you recall definition of money, the definition of goods, initial classes we have learned? Okay. Here. What is goods means? Every kind of movable goods other than money and securities. Okay. Here you see definition of service other than money and securities. So money and securities are not included. They are outside the purview of GST. Okay, are you getting this point? Money securities does not attract. Then what is point 5? Please read it.
Supply should be made for a consideration. Exceptions are there.
Yes. So primarily, we have to understand when we say supply, there should be some kind of consideration. But there are exceptions. Is it not? We have already seen what are the lists, what is the list, what are the exceptions list. In all those cases, even if there is no consideration, still they will be regarded as supply. Point 6. What is written?
Supply should be made in the course of or furtherance of business.
Yes, this concept also we need to understand. That when you talk about the supply, it has to be made in the course of business or in the furtherance of business. So what is the furtherance? What is in the course of? This we will be making detailed analysis in further. But right now we have to see that the supply should be a commercial transaction. That means in the context of business, supply should have been made. Right, that we have to keep in mind. And what is the seventh analysis?
Supply should be made by a taxable person.
Okay.
Supply should be taxable supply.
Taxable supply and taxable person definitions we have also covered. That is also relevant for us to understand. Okay. So again, I repeat. Goods and services are both for a consideration in the course or furtherance of the business by a taxable person. It is a taxable supply. And if it is a taxable supply, then it will attract GST. Okay. That is why the importance of some. That's why supply is so important. We need to identify whether it's a supply or not. Okay. Few exceptions also quickly we'll be learning. Certain transactions are deemed to be supply even without consideration. We know that a list of supplies which are, even if there is no consideration, it will be regarded as supply. Now, point two is important for us. Please read second point.
Import of service for consideration, even not in course of furtherance of business, is also supply.
So even this is one more exception, that import of service, not local service, import of service for a consideration, even if it is not in the course of or in the furtherance of the business, still it is regarded as supply. Then certain transactions are kept out of supply. We have seen the last schedule 3. Even if all parameters exist, still they are not supply. Certain activities are treated either supply of goods or service. Certain transactions can be notified or be treated as supply of goods, not service, and vice versa. So these are some exceptional things we have to know. Okay. Now, this is the primary analysis we had made. What we did, we tried to understand the definition first. We need to see what are the content of the schedules. The three schedules are important for us to understand the concept of supply. And after this primary analysis, we'll make some attempt to make a detailed analysis. Almost similar kind of analysis, but we'll try to go a little deeper. Inclusive definition, now we know. So section has not tried to define anything, define the scope of supply exhaustively. List is not exhaustive, that we have seen what surcharge is used, and also it says it includes so many things that one can understand. There are certain parameters of supply. Supply should be of goods or services. Supply of anything other than our goods and services like money, securities, etc. does not attract GST, because money is neither goods. Securities are neither goods nor services. Supply should be made for a consideration. So consideration is important. Supply should be made in the course or furtherance of business. These are the three key parameters. But for this parameter 2, that is for consideration, and parameter 3, that is for furtherance of the business or in the course of business, there are exceptions. Exceptions are there with regard to second and third parameters. These two parameters has got some exceptions. Okay. So there will be some supplies where consideration is not there. Still it will be regarded as supply. There will be some supply which is not in the course of business or not in the furtherance of the business. Still that will be regarded as supply. Okay. Let us see what are these few exceptions. Yeah, so the same thing what I explained to you about these exceptions of parameter 2 and 3 is written here in this slide. You can read it later on. And you have already seen GST law has classified certain goods as supply, goods as services. I have already explained you this concept. You also know government is empowered to notify the transaction that is to be treated as supply of goods and not as supply of services. Or in the reverse way, that can be treated as supply of services and not as supply of goods. Government is empowered to do that. Now, at this stage, if you try to summarize that what we have learned regarding supply, now have a look at this chart. This will clarify many things. Concept of supply includes what are the things which are included? 1, 2, 3, 4. Can you read this thing one by one?
Supply for consideration in course or furtherance of business, section 7, subsection 1, clause A.
Yes.
importation of services for consideration, whether or not in course or furtherance of business.
Here you have to remember importation of service, whether or not in the course or furtherance of business. Okay. So even if service is imported which is not in connection with the business, still that is supply. Then point three.
Supply without consideration.
Schedule 1 covers that thing. We have seen the activities. Then
activities to be treated as supply of goods or supply of services.
We have seen that Schedule 2. In some specific situation, it says these are the supply of goods and these are the supply of services. And the definition of supply excludes the negative items, negative list items. That means I am talking about Schedule 3. Okay. Schedule 3 contains these items which are neither supply of goods nor supply of services. Now, just give me a minute. Now, we had discussed earlier what is the meaning of goods and what is the meaning of services. We'll do a little analysis on that because that is also relevant. Goods means every kind of movable property, you know, and includes actionable claims, growing crops, grass, things attached to or forming a part of land, which are agreed to be sold before supply or under contract of supply. That is the meaning of goods. Services means anything other than goods and includes activities relating to use of money. Money is excluded. Money and securities are excluded from both the definitions. Goods excludes money and securities. Services also excludes money and securities. But activities related to the money, that means, let us say, money changing activities, it's all these things we had discussed in our earlier classes. They are services. Conversion of money by cash or other form or other mode from one form to another form. Okay. Current from one denomination to another denomination. All these things are services. And they'll be called as supply of services. Okay, this is these two definitions, these two understanding is required. And supply includes sale, transfer, barter, exchange, license, rental, sale, lease, disposal. Most of the things are, why most of the things, almost none of the things are defined in the GST law. You have to read some other law to understand the meaning of sale, to understand the meaning of barter, to understand the meaning of transfer. This meaning has to be understood by referring to other literatures, then only you can see. But everything is included. Consideration is important. But what is consideration? That definition we have seen. It can be in cash, it can be in kind. We'll be analyzing that aspect also. And it should be in the course or furtherance of the business. That aspect also need to be analyzed. What is the meaning of in the course of business, of furtherance of business? How one can prove that it is for furtherance of the business. That has to be seen. Okay. So, at this stage, you can see all these things, sale, transport, battery, etc. We need to understand one by one. So, first what I'll do, we'll start understanding the meaning of sale. That is one of the essential ingredient of supply, you know. Sale, you know, it means transfer of ownership of title of the property. Okay, normally it has been defined to understand this, to get the complete meaning of the sale. So we might have to refer to sale of goods act. Okay, here sale of goods act, if you refer, it means it's a contract whereby the seller transfers or agrees to transfer the property in goods to the buyer for a price. Seller is agreeing to transfer some property to the buyer for a price. That concept is called as sale. Okay. What is transfer? We have to see the dictionary meaning here. Transfer. It means convey or remove from one place, person or any other. Okay. Removing or conveying from one place or from one person to another person. To pass or hand over, all these things covers another meaning of transfer. You have to take the dictionary meaning. Barter, as you have understood, we have to go by the dictionary meaning also. It is not defined in law, in our act. So exchange of goods and services for other goods and services. Okay, what is exchange? I had given you that exchange also. Exchange is an act of giving or taking one thing for another. So barter and exchange both are covered under supply. Okay. An example of, you can say, barter supply can be a doctor providing medical consultancy to a barber and barber providing haircut services to a doctor. You can say this is an exchange of, or you can say, barter transaction between a doctor and a barber, and both will be regarded as supply. Now, license, lease, rental, disposal. Quickly, we'll very briefly understand what is the meaning. License means a specific permission given or granted by a competent authority. Some authority must be giving a specific permission. And without permission, you cannot do, or if you do, it will become unlawful. That means an unlawful act or something which is otherwise unlawful, legally not permissible. One person may be given license to do that. Okay. So through licensing also, it's possible to supply goods, supply services. Okay. Disposal includes sale, place, giving away. All these are the meaning of disposal. Rental, you know, when arrangements is made to give something on rent, it may be a house, it may be machinery, etc. That is the meaning of rental. Disposal I had already explained. Okay. Now, if you analyze the meaning of consideration definition part we have already said. And from the very beginning you understood what is the meaning of consideration. But if you're coming to analysis part, you have to remember that it is not always in the form of money. Consideration may come in kind also. Consideration need not always flow from the recipient. This is one more aspect. Consideration may flow from third parties also. So one is supplier, other one is the recipient. But consideration may flow from the third party. Okay, third party can be anyone. But consideration does not include, first of all, subsidy. This we have discussed earlier. If the central government, state government, etc. are giving subsidy, then you cannot say this is a consideration which is flowing from a third party. No, subsidy is not a consideration. Okay. And also consideration doesn't include deposit. If the recipient has deposited some money with the supplier, that deposit will not be regarded as a consideration till such time when the supplier applies such deposit for consideration. If supplier is applying the deposit money for consideration, then only it will be regarded as a consideration. Otherwise, deposit is not a consideration. Okay. Now, at this stage, if I ask you, consideration excludes two things specifically. When I talk about the consideration of supply, two things are excluded. Can you tell me what are these two things? Who can tell me? Consideration does not include A and B. What are these items? Can you reply? Well, this question is to Drishti. Drishti, are you hearing me? In her absence, Shweta. Shweta, you are hearing? Who can reply this?
Sir, there are two things. First is the subsidy, which is given by the central government or state government. And second is the deposit for the supply of goods or services or both.
Who is replying?
Sir Aditi here.
Okay, Aditi. Thank you, Aditi. Yeah, these are the two exceptions. Okay, why we need to learn this thing? Because this is quite helpful to us to do tax planning also. And GST tax planning. You have to keep in the mind that if you can make some arrangement to receive deposits, till we apply that GST liability is not there. But whereas if the customer gives some advance, then GST liability will be there. That will be considered as a consideration. Government subsidies are not a part of the consideration. Consequently, GST is not applicable on them. So exceptions are important for us. You have to remember it. Okay, you have to not only understand, you have to remember it so that you can apply it in GST tax planning. Right. So now I'm giving you some example, or let me ask you a question. Let us say who of you are answering. Okay. So I guess all of you are present. Now you have to respond. The situation is like this. I'm giving you a situation now. Let us say one art exhibition is going on and different artists have contributed their artwork, which will be displayed. So artist has supplied that artwork to the art exhibition and these things are displayed. Now my question is to you, whether the supply of art material by the artists to the art exhibition will be regarded as supply or not? Question I'll be asking you and you have to reply. This question, let me ask others. What is your view? Whether it will be regarded as supply or not? You may tell your view. Others, you may unmute and speak. In his absence, yes, Rudra. Yeah, others, you are there. Yeah. What is your view? Did you understand the case?
No, sir. Can you repeat, sir?
Case is like this. One art exhibition is going on. Or art exhibition is going to be started. And various artists, they are supplying. They are not exactly supplying. They are
what, sir? Various?
Artists.
Okay.
Artists, they have given their art material to the exhibition for display. Okay, it will be sold there. Now, these articles, goods, artwork, etc. are handed over by the artist to the art exhibition. The question is that whether this activity will be regarded as a supply. If yes, why? If it's not, also, why? You can, your answer may be right or wrong, that doesn't matter. I just want your
view. Actually, your voice is breaking, sir.
My voice is breaking.
Half of the things are not audible, sir. Half of the things.
Okay. Is it breaking for all?
No, sir.
My voice
no,
is...
No, sir.
Okay. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Aditi? Okay. Others? So, I'm setting the question now. Mridula, others, there might be some internet issue with you.
Yes. Sorry, sir.
No issue. We can have discussion some other time. Mridula, are you there? Okay. Ratikant, you are there? Shweta? Okay, now question is open to you. Anyone can reply. Who can reply? Who can share his or our helper's viewpoint on this?
Sir, it is a
what is your point of view? Goods. Yeah, share your views. Anybody can participate.
I guess it is a supply because there is a for the furtherance of business there is a
any other point of view? Anyone having a this is Aditi talking, no? Aditi?
Yes, sir.
So your view is that it is a supply.
Yes, sir. Because there is a transfer for the furtherance of business.
Alright. Acha. Who any other person who can support Aditi or can give a different view?
So it's an importation of service too. So that's why also it's a supply.
Yeah, it's an importation.
Yes, sir.
Now importation means here we'll see import.
Sir, right. You asked.
So, like, sir, the art is supplied by the artist to the
art exhibition.
Art exhibition, yes, sir.
This is Drishti.
Sorry, sir, right? I didn't get you.
Yeah, Drishti.
Yes, sir.
Your point is that it is supplied because it is an importation of service.
So they have shared their work, so that's why I'm just guessing, sir.
No. You see, first of all, when this is supplied, we will categorize it as a goods or service. Art materials.
Sir, it is a good.
It's a goods, no? Yeah, right. Your view is okay. Never worry if your answer goes wrong. Also, that doesn't matter. Who can share views? I would like to listen the views.
So the art exhibition acts as an agent.
Did you understand the situation, all of you? Suryans, you are saying something.
So the art exhibition acts as an agent between the artists and the buyers. So okay. It's a supply of good.
Right. Okay. Well, so, but my view is slightly different. That's my view. Just a minute. I will go for screen sharing again. I will be explaining you that concept now. Yeah. So we are discussing now. Consideration is important. And in this case, what I told you, goods are supplied by the artist to the art exhibition. Is it not? Now, in this transaction, whether any consideration is there? Keep on responding, whether consideration is there or not. For this, yes, sir. Consideration is there?
Yes, sir.
Consideration, you see, you are saying yes, sir, but you see, consideration will come only when this art material will be sold in the exhibition.
So they are given to the art exhibition for selling purpose only.
For display. If you are understanding that they are given means it is sold to the art exhibition, then okay, your answer is right. If you are thinking that it is given to the exhibition means it is sold to the exhibition and exhibition will be selling it, then your answer is right. But if you say if it is given for display, I think I have used the word display. If they are given for display, then whether consideration is there? Let us assume it's for display. Whether consideration is there or not?
No, sir.
No, consideration is not there. If it's not there, consideration, is it covered in the list of the supplies or list of the activities where it is still a supply even if there is no consideration? That answer is also no. So consequently, this will not be regarded as a supply. Okay. Okay. But if you feel or if your understanding is that artists gave their artworks to the art exhibition, and got some money, then definitely.
So you mentioned display, then you said it is for sale. That's why.
It is for sale means exhibition will be selling. No? Okay, if you have understood that it is a sale between the artist and the exhibition, then your answer is right. Okay, if your understanding is like that, your answer is right. Otherwise, your answer is wrong. Okay.
Sir, but if there is a sale, the art exhibition would be acting as an agent, right? In the sale.
Yes.
So then what it would be in that case?
When sale will be made, whether yes, it is made by the irrespective of the fact, whether it is made by the principal or by agent.
Yes, sir.
That's the supply.
Okay.
When sale is made, that's the supply. But till that time, when sale is not made, there is absence of consideration, which is one important ingredient of supply. Consequently, that will not be regarded as supply. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
But your thinking is right. If you have thought it differently, your answer is right. Now, if you try to summarize, consideration means payment of money, and consideration may be in kind also. Deposits, whether that to be forms a part of consideration or not. Deposits will be.
No, sir, it won't.
It will not be considered as consideration, but it will be considered only when the supplier applies such deposits as consideration. Okay. When the supplier applies. Are you getting the meaning of this? When supplier applies? Or should I explain?
Sir, elaborate.
Yes. Sure. Now, just give me a minute. I will stop sharing this. Yeah. Let us say I am a supplier. Okay. You want to buy something from me. Okay. Right. Let us say I am selling laptops. You want to buy laptops. You want to buy 10 laptops and you have deposited with me 2 lakh rupees. So when you have given it 2 lakh rupees, the question is that I have received some money. If it is a consideration, so immediately I should pay GST on this. Is it not? Because consideration received for supply. But point is that you have not paid it as an advance money. You have paid it as deposit. So if you have kept giving me a deposit money, then what I am doing, I am keeping it as a deposit. Consequently, that is not a part of my consideration. And I am not paying GST on this. I am keeping it as a deposit. But when you will buy a laptop, let us say you are buying a laptop, then what I will be doing, I will be giving you a bill. And in that bill, I will write due this much total amount of, I am billing for 10 lakh rupees and 2 lakh rupees you have already paid. I will write in the bill or not? And your final amount, another 8 lakh you have to pay me. Is it not? The moment I am mentioning there that you have already paid 2 lakh rupees as deposit, that means I'm applying that deposit against that bill. Right? In that moment, that takes the shape of the consideration. So I'll be paying GST. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now we'll go back to that PPT again. So, deposits are not considered as consideration, but they will be considered as consideration only when the supplier applies a deposit for consideration. Okay. Consideration may include monetary value of any act or forbearance for supply. And this consideration may flow from outsiders also. It's not necessary that only it has to be paid by the recipient. It may flow from outsiders. But it may flow from outsiders, but only one kind of outside payment is excluded, that is subsidy from central or state governments. That will not be considered as a consideration from outsiders. That will be totally excluded from the definition of consideration. Okay. So that is why consideration is important. But there are certain exceptions we have already seen, where even if there is no consideration, it is still regarded as. Okay, is it clear up to this?
Yes, sir.
Now, next one more important analysis we'll make, that what is the meaning of in the course or furtherance of the business? This exactly means in the course of business or in furtherance of the business. Meaning that the particular transaction or the particular activity must be a commercial transaction. So if in your personal capacity you are doing something, or the supplier has supplied something in his personal capacity, then that is not in the course of business or not in the furtherance of the business. Then that is not a, you can say, that is not a supply. Okay, that's not a supply. So can you give some example? Anyone, if you can think a particular transaction which is done like this. Let us say there is a restaurant owner who supplies food. Right, you are his friend, and sometimes you are going to the restaurant, and let us say you enjoyed the food. And let us say when you are going there, the restaurant owner is supplying you the food in his personal capacity, as a friend, as a relative, or he is offering you some. Right. So if that is the kind of case, you can say this is not in the course of business. That means he is not exactly selling you. He is offering you. It is not in the course of business, or it is not in furtherance of the business. Consequently, that will not be regarded as supply. Okay. Now, the definition of business we have understood earlier. If you analyze that further, business definitions we have already understood. I had already explained trade, commerce, manufacture, profession, everything. All these things are related now, covered under the definition of business. It also includes any activity incidental or ancillary to the business. Okay, any activity of the same nature, even if there is no volume, no continuity, no regularity, still all these things will be considered as business. It includes supply or acquisition of goods, including capital goods and services. It includes all these activities which are in connection with commencement or closure of the business. All these things are supply. All these things are business. All these activities are business. Provision of facilities by club, association, etc. to members, they are also business. Admission into a premises for some consideration, that is also business. Services provided by holder of the office in the course or furtherance of the trade, profession, etc., they are also business. Activities of race club, including services provided by a totalizer, license to bookmaker, all these activities are business. Any activity by government or local authorities, public authorities, all these things are included. Okay. So once we know the business, then we can understand that what is the meaning of furtherance of the business. So the supply that we are making, that should be connected to the business. Then only you can say the supply is in the furtherance of the business accordingly. When consideration is there, that will be regarded either as supply of goods or supply of services. Okay. So like this, we'll discuss some other examples in our next class. Okay, we'll continue our discussion on supply. We'll try to understand few more issues related to the supply. Once that is over, then go to the other part, what is the composite supply, bundled supply, all these concepts are also there. So we'll be covering that. We'll stop here right now. But do you have any query? Do you have any issues? Let me know.
No, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. We'll catch up in your next class. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.